Hello students, in today's video I am going to discuss about trigonometric functions. It is the third chapter of plus 1 NCERT mathematics. Before I proceed with the trigonometric functions, you already completed this chapter in or you know some basics about this chapter in class 10th. What is the meaning of trigonometry? Trigonometry basically comprises of two words, two Greek words, trigon and metron, means three sides measurement. But later on, the study of right angle triangle came into existence. That is, trigonometry is the branch of mathematics in which we study about the right angle triangle. There are various applications used by sea captains for navigation, surveyor in civil engineering department to map out new lands, designing of electric circuits, describing state of an atom, predicting height of tides in oceans, and many more areas. Now, what is the meaning of angle? Suppose OA is initial side and OB is terminal side, then this angle is positive angle. And if the movement is downward, generally we can say that this movement is anti-clockwise movement and this movement is clockwise movement. Clockwise angle is negative and anti-clockwise angle is positive. Now, how to measure the degree? We already started this concept in 7th or 8th class, how to design the angle. This angle is 180 degree, and if the circle is complete, this angle is 360 degree. It's minus 30 and this angle is 270 degree. This point is important. What is the meaning of radian? Let us first read the definition. Read, radian is an angle subtended by an arc equal to the length of the radius at the center of the circle. I repeat again, radian is an angle. This angle is radian angle subtended by an arc. It is designed by arc AB equal to the length of the radius, and this arc length is equal to the length of the radius, and it is designed at the center of the circle. Then this angle is known as 1 radian angle. Now we know that circumference of the circle is 2 pi r. If r is 1 unit, then circumference is 2 pi. And this circumference is in radians because we are considering the radian, but this angle is 360 degree. It means pi can be written as 180 degree when 360 degree divided by 2. Now one more derivation, that is theta is equal to L upon R. Theta is the angle made by an arc at the center of the circle, and arc length is L and radius is R. Now arc AB is equal to radius. Arc AB is equal to radius. Then this angle is 1 radian. When arc length AB is equal to arc, this value is R, then angle is equal to 1 radian. If this length is 1 unit, then the angle is 1 over r. Clearly, I apply the unitary method. If length is L, then this angle is L upon r. It means theta can be written as L upon r depending upon any length of the arc. This point is again important. Actually, we are doing the basic things. before continuing with the exercise. If we have to convert the angle degree measure into radian, then what we have to do? Simply multiply by pi and divided by 180, then you can convert this angle into radian. And if we have to convert radian into degree, then simply insert the value of pi, that is 180 degree. If this value is not given, then multiply by 180 divided by pi. Now let us start with the exercise. First, four angles are given: 25 degree, minus 47 degree 30 minute, 240 degree and 520 degree. And we have to convert these angles into radian. Simply multiply by pi over 180, then cancel the value. You can find out the value in radian. And what about the second one? It's 30 minute. In first step, we have to convert 30 minute into degree. And 30 minute is clearly written as 30 divided by 60 degree. It means it's 1 over 2 degree. Then take LCM, it's 95 over 2. Then multiply by pi over 180. Then cancel the value and we will get minus 19 over 72 pi radian. And third and fourth part is simple. Simply multiply these values by pi over 180 degree. It's 4 pi over 3. And here, when we multiply by pi over 180, simply cancel the value, then 26 pi over 9 radian. In question number 2, we have to convert the degree measure into the, find the degree measure. We have to convert into degree when radian value is given to us. 11 over 16 radian is given to us and we have to convert it into degree. Simply multiply the value by 180 over pi. Then insert the value of pi. After calculating, we will get 315 divided by 8. Now, how to convert this value into degree, minute and second? Simply divide the value 8 into 3. Then 75, 72, division is simple and remainder is 3. Now multiply the remainder by 60 so that we can calculate the value in a minute. Again, multiply the remainder by 60 so that we can calculate the value in second. In this way, the answer is 39 degree, 22 minute and 30 second. Next question is also simple question. Minus 4 radian, simply multiply 180 over pi, then insert the value of pi, then 2520 divided by 11. Again, we can calculate the value 229 degree, 5 minute and 27 second. 1 is remainder, multiply by 60. Then again 5 is remainder, again multiply by 60. You can find out the value. Part 3rd, simply insert pi is equal to 180 or you can cancel pi by pi and answer is 5 into 60, it's 300. Similarly, you can calculate 7 pi over 6, multiply 180 over pi, cancel pi with each other, 6 into 30, 7 into 30, it's 210. Please keep in mind when you have to convert radian into degree, multiply by 80 divided by pi, and when you have to convert degree into radian, simply multiply by pi over 180. Now the question is of a statement type. The wheel makes 360 revolutions in 1 minute. Through how many radians does it turn in 1 second? Now 360 revolution in 1 minute, what is the meaning of this? It means 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. It means in 60 seconds, 360 revolutions are there. It means in 1 second, 6 revolutions are there. But one revolution is equal to 2 pi radian, because in one revolution, the circle covers 360 degree. It means 2 pi radians are there. It means 6 revolutions is equal to 12 pi radians. Question number 4. Find the degree measure of the angle subtended at the center of a circle of radius 100 cm by an arc of length 22 cm. Okay. You have to calculate the value of angle, that is theta. L is given to you and R is given to you. Simply apply the formula, theta is equal to L upon R. Now this value is in radian. You have to convert this into degrees. Look at the statement. Find the degree measure. It means if it's in radian, then 22 over 100 is okay. But you have to convert this angle into degree. That's why I multiply by 180 and divided by pi. Then insert the value of pi. You will get 126 over 10. Then convert this angle into degree and minute by dividing the value. Question number 5. In a circle of diameter 40 cm, the length of the chord is 20 cm. Find the length of the minor arc of the chord. Now, look at the statement. In a circle of diameter 40 cm. Draw a circle with diameter 40 cm. It means radius is 20 cm. Length of the chord is again 20 cm. When I join OB, it means it will be again 20 cm. Because this one is radius. OA is equal to OB. Now, the triangle is equilateral triangle. It means the angle is 60 degree. Now, look at the solution. Diameter is 40, radius is 20. Okay. According to the statement, AB is 20. Join OB. Now, triangle OAB is equilateral triangle. Angle is 60 degree. Convert it into radian. That means we can write pi over 3. Now, find the value of L, that is arc length. L is equal to R multiplied by theta. It's 20 multiplied pi over 3. Answer is 20 pi divided by 3. You have to find the length of maybe alteration in examination is there. Now two circles are given to you. If in two circles arcs are the same length, both the lengths are same, arc length is same, angle, one angle is 60 degree and second is 75 degree, and we have to calculate the ratio of radius. We already know theta is equal to L upon R. First theta is 60 degree, 60 into pi over 180, because in this statement theta is in radian, L upon R1, 75 multiply pi over 180, L upon R2. Simply I insert the value of theta and radius. Now in the first statement, L is equal to 60 multiply pi over 180 multiply R1, and similar is the case in second. Now equate both the terms, because this value is equal to L and this value is also equal to L. Pi over 180 cancel with each other. 15 into 4 and 15 into 5, R1 divided by R2 is equal to 5 divided by 4. In this way, you can calculate the ratio. Question number 7 is again the simple question. Find the angle in radian. You have to calculate this angle, that is theta, through which a pendulum swings. The moment is like this. If its length is 75 cm, its length of the pendulum, and tip describes an arc of the length 10 cm, 15 cm and 21 cm, it means three answers will be there. In first case, theta is equal to L upon R, it means 10 divided by 75, answer is 2 over 15. And in second case, it's 15 divided by 75, and in third case, it's 21 divided by 75. In this way, you can calculate the answers. Thank you. In the next video, I will discuss about second exercise and the basics about second exercise.